And what grade are you in now? 12th grade. So you're graduating. When's graduation? Are you excited? Is it like it can't come fast enough?
Yeah, I just can't believe I'm a 12th grader. Like, it just feels like it's going too fast.
Really? You're like the first kid I've talked to and they're like, it's going too fast. Really? Usually, like, when I talk to somebody who's in high school, I can't wait to get out. I can't wait to do, you know what I mean? But you said it went too fast. So what's your favorite subject here, Blake?
Well, economics.
Really? What do you like about that?
Just like the business stuff out of it, and it talks about real life.
So what do you, so speaking of business and real life, what do you want to be when you grow up? And when I say grow up, I mean like when you get out of college.
Culinary arts teacher.
Can you cook now? Mm-hmm. Okay, Allison, let's talk real. I burn oatmeal in the microwave. So I can't understand how people like you cook every day, because here I am burning oatmeal in the microwave. This is no exaggeration. This happened like a month ago. And that was the day that I said I quit. I'm not trying anything else. So how do you, like, I mean, I guess you can cook now, right? What is it? Like, is it patience? What do I need to be able to be even a decent cook? This is a real question I'm asking you, Allison. I need assistance. She's like, no, I can't help you. I find it very, a couple friends of mine are chefs. One of them is the executive chef over at Raymond James Stadium. And the time he takes to make like just salad dressing is incredible to me. But how do you know like what flavors go with what and what you shouldn't add with this? You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, how do you figure that out?
You just have to try different flavors.
Oh, I see. So it's like trial and error.
Yeah.
Okay, so if you're a culinary arts teacher, what would be your job? So like, do you teach like high school kids, or would you teach like adults how to cook?
I want to teach high school kids, but I'm kind of edgy on them because they're high school kids.
I love it, yeah. They are a handful. But I hear that you're awesome, that you're not like the norm, so that's kind of cool. So you're in the Urban Teacher Program, and so you've been doing it for 4 years? You had to do it the whole time?
Yes.
What made you want to get into the program?
Well, at first I didn't know that Blake had a teaching program here, and then I wanted to be a teacher ever since I was like little, so I thought it would be a good idea to get in the program.
Yeah.
To learn stuff about it.
Yeah. What do you think some of the most important things, because I'm not familiar with the program, I've just read a couple things online. What do you think some of the most important parts of the program are? Like, if there's a ninth grader coming up next year and they want to know about it, what would you tell them that you've learned? And just like real easy, like just basic, like surface stuff. Like, what are some of the things that you know now that you wouldn't have known if you weren't in that program?
The teachers have to have really, really good patience. If not, then, yeah. Teachers are really good role models. Like, they don't have to wake up every day, and they do it because they want to do it, not just because they have to. And you have to love your job to become a teacher.
So, a little secret about working, because I mean, once you get out of college, you're gonna have to work like for the rest of your life, okay? Until you get to be like 62. So one thing that I learned growing up, and I've been doing TV now for almost 10 years, if you love what you do, you don't have to work a day in your life. And that's the cool thing. And I find that people who want to be teachers, they love doing that. And they know that it's something that's helping people, and they just love leaving their mark. You know what I mean? In television news, we leave our mark in a different way, but you all actually teach people how to be good members of society. Like, it's not just teaching them academics, but it's teaching them how to just be good people. You know what I mean? Have you learned that too, like being in the UTA program?
Yes.
Yeah. Talk about taking that into the real world, though. Like, if there were something that you could, ages ago, but when I was in high school, I learned some things that, like, you can't learn in a book. Like, you can't learn it in a textbook, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So it was like stuff that you actually needed somebody who's had real world experience to tell you. What are some of those things?
The never give up on your dreams. You just have to go for it. Like, if you give up on it, then you'll regret it in life.
Do you see some kids here at your school, in, like, specifically, who you wish maybe they would have gone through the program because they'd be a little bit different if they did?
Yeah.
Talk to me about that. Talk to me about, you don't have to use any names, but talk to me about how you wish that other people or more people would do the program.
Like, if more people went through the program, then they probably wouldn't be acting like they were, like, getting in fights and everything.
Because the program has taught you patience.
Yeah.
And how to deal with people, which is something that you'll have to do if you're a teacher. So what school do you want to go to?
I got accepted to the art institution for the International Culinary School there.
Wow. Where is that?
It's by South University.
Yeah.
It's by the stadium.
So what is your favorite dish to make?
Because I go there on Saturdays, so I'm getting my college some of my classes out of the way, and we made this one white sauce. Can't remember what it's called, but it's one of the mother sauces. And
okay, what does that mean? If it's a mother sauce,
like, you can make it into different sauces.
So that's kind of like the starter
yeah.
kit. I need a starter kit.
Yeah.
I need anything that's got like a packet, and then I just add water to it. Okay, that's what I need. So go on about the mother sauce.
It's one of the mother sauces. Like, you can make it's a white sauce. You can make Alfredo out of it.
Oh. Now, my jam is marinara. I'm not really an Alfredo type of person, but I do like Alfredo on, like, seafood.
Mm-hmm.
I don't really like the marinara on seafood. So that's my thing. So, okay, you go to school. That's kind of cool. So you go to school on Saturdays, and then that's kind of giving you credits
yeah.
for the fall.
Yep.
Ooh, I like that. Yep. Well, good for you. So graduation is, you said, May 19th.
Yes.
And then the graduation from this program is tomorrow.
Yes.
So you're super excited. Tell me, like, one thing that you will miss about Blake High School.
Miss Williams.
Mm.
I miss Miss Williams. She was a really good teacher. Well, she is still a good teacher.
Yeah. What about her is so great? I've only met her today. All I know is that her name is Miss Williams, and she's a really nice lady. She was nice to me when I met her. Tell me what I need to know about her.
Miss Williams won't give up on you. Even if you give up on yourself, she won't give up on you. She'll make you try.
That's a lot what this program is about.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So the character GPS people who came in, Deb and Jeff, like, are they basically teaching you kind of some of the same principles that you were learning at UTA, but just reinforcing them for you?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's awesome. Have you seen a change in the program since they came along, like just additional resources that you can use?
Yeah. Now I'm starting to set goals. Like, before I wasn't, and now I'm trying to reach my goals.
Why is it important? I mean, everybody's got a different answer when it comes to this, but why do you think it's important to set goals for yourself?
Because if you don't, then you probably won't reach any.
Because in your mind, you don't know where you're going.
Yeah.
You know, I always, I liken it to, you ever ridden on an airplane?
No.
Okay, so when you get on an airplane, the first thing they do, if this is any flight you get on, everybody sits down, and then they read you these safety instructions, okay? Nobody's listening. I'm over here playing with my earbuds, trying to figure out where my water is, the person next to me is sitting too close, the air is, it's just so much going on, right? But they're in the front of the plane, and they're telling you all these instructions. It's like 5 minutes of instructions, safety instructions in case the plane goes down. In my mind, all I'm thinking about is, if this plane goes down, I'm not going to remember anything you're saying anyway. I'm just going to think the plane's going down, right? But one of the things that they teach you is you have to put your oxygen mask on before you can put it on somebody else. So in other words, like, you got to help yourself before
yeah.
you can help somebody else. When I was reading about this program, it seems like that's what character GPS is teaching you, UTA is teaching you, your teacher is teaching you, that you got to help yourself and find your goals before you can do anything for these other students that are coming up. Right? I gave you a long explanation to that point, but I just wanted to illustrate my point. There was the whole, I'm telling you, if you get on an airplane, you're going to think about me, because you're going to be like, oh my God, these instructions, you should totally listen to the instructions. But they're the same instructions every time. They're FAA regulated. They have to say the same thing every time. Unless you fly Southwest, and sometimes they make it a big joke. But yeah, just put on your oxygen mask before you put on somebody else's. That's all you need to know. It was nice to meet you. Look, you made it. Look, that was it. Yay.